Welcome to Orbazonia Church of the Nazarene and the funeral service and service of celebration for Reverend Darrell Nicklow. I want to thank you on behalf of the family for showing your support and for being here. As we all know, this is the beginning of a process, and they would appreciate your encouragement in the days ahead. Whenever you think of the family, remember them in prayer, and also send them a note over the next few weeks. For today is the beginning of a different journey for them. If you would, please silence your cell phones at this time, if you already haven't. I'm going to read through the obituary so that we have all of the information, and then I'm going to ask Dr. Bowser if he'll come, and he has something to read from the General Church of the Nazarene and from the district. Reverend Darrell Reed Nicklow, age 70, of Amy Lane, Tyrone, Pennsylvania, passed on Saturday, March 4th, at his home. Born July 18th, 1952, at Confluence, Pennsylvania. He was the son, was a son of the late Harry Nicklow and Barbara Beckett Nicklow, who survives in Fort Hill, PA. He was united in marriage to the former Lyndon Reckner on November 27th, 1971, at the Confluence Church of the Nazarene. Miss Nicklow survives at their home. He is also survived by two sons, Jason Nicklow and wife Kimberly of Smithfield, Pennsylvania, Travis Nicklow and wife Angie of Heston, Pennsylvania, three grandchildren, Olivia, Luke, and Bailey, one step-grandson, Joshua Buffia, and wife Tia, three great-grandsons, Brody, Beau, and Brooks, and one brother, Edward Nicklow of Somersville, West Virginia. Reverend Nicklow had served as a Nazarene minister since July 20, 1974. Alongside his faithful wife, Linda, he graduated from Nazarene Bible College in Colorado Springs, Colorado, on June 3, 1974, and later received a bachelor's and master's degree from Evangelical Bible College and Seminary in Green Acres, Florida. He was ordained by the Pittsburgh District of the Nazarene on July 30, 1976. Reverend Nicklow has served as pastor of six Nazarene churches over the past 47 plus years, all in Pennsylvania. Springboro, St. Petersburg, Sharpsville, Du Bois, Homer City, and here at Orbazonia for 28 and a half years. He was involved in radio ministry for 37 years. His program was called God's Word for Today and aired most recently on WJSM out of Martinsburg. He also had written heart and soul columns for the religious page of the Valley Log newspaper for 17 years. Reverend Nicklow also preached at many revivals across Pennsylvania during his ministry. Reverend Nicklow was a life member of the National Rifle Association for many years and a lifelong hunter, fisherman, and he especially loved fishing for trout, deer hunting, and pheasant hunting with his bird dogs. Today we celebrate his life and the heritage that he leaves in our care. Dr. Bowser?
To those words that have already been shared, allow me to add my words of thanksgiving for his faithful ministry. It is a privilege to share two letters. One letter is from his colleagues across the Mid-Atlantic District, and I read this to you, to the family and friends of Pastor Darrell Nicklow. The Mid-Atlantic District family joins me in expressing our deep sympathy at the death of Pastor Darrell Nicklow, and yet we celebrate his safe arrival home in the arms of Jesus. Since July 20, 1974, Pastor Darrell and his faithful wife Linda have answered God's call and served with distinction. Graduate of Nazarene Bible College, Evangelical Bible College and Seminary, ordained by the Pittsburgh District Church of the Nazarene. Only eternity will reveal the depth of his contribution and those lives whom he has touched during his ministry. We grieve your loss, and yet are assured that the words he proclaimed has welcomed him to his reward with these words, "Well done, good and faithful servant." May God's grace sustain you in these days. Know that you are loved and that you are being lifted in prayer. Earlier this morning, I received a note from the Board of General Superintendents of the Church of the Nazarene, 6 Board of General Superintendents, one who has jurisdictional responsibility. And today, Dr. Gustavo Crocker is in the Mesoamerica region, but took time to send a letter. And I'd like to read it because it is very, very encouraging. In a time when it maybe feels like you're alone and no one knows and no one sees your ministry, know that your husband's ministry was both seen, deeply appreciated. Hear these words, and you'll receive this letter in your home, but it's addressed to you. And it just simply says this: "Dear Mrs. Nicklow, greetings in the strong name of Jesus. I've learned recently of the death of your husband, Reverend Darrell Nicklow, and the Board of General Superintendents join me in expressing sorrow at your loss and wonder at the celebration he's experiencing in heaven. For more than 47 years, he faithfully served God in the Church of the Nazarene as a devoted and caring pastor. His deep roots in the Orbisonia community spoke of God's steadfast love. His commitment to Jesus was evident in his many years, proclaiming the good news both in print and across the airwaves. Only eternity will reveal the many lives he touched for Christ and the kingdom. As we grieve, we find comfort in knowing Pastor Darrell has already heard the Master say, 'Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord.' Your sorrow now is profound, yet we know that someday you will be reunited with your husband in the presence of the Lord. And may God's grace and love and mercy strengthen you and give you the courage to ever be true to Christ." Dr. Crocker closes with these words: "Please know our thoughts and our prayers are with you." And he has signed it, and you'll receive this. And to his words and to the words I've shared from his colleagues across the district, we want you to know that we love you. And we believe that God has used both you and your husband in powerful ways and will use these moments to remind others of the faithfulness of God that your husband both taught, preached, and lived. May God bless you.
I'm going to ask Reverend Porterfield if he would come at this time and pray.
Thank you. Let us pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for your faithfulness, your mercy and grace. We thank you, Lord, for the example of our departed brother. We thank you, Lord, for the life that he lived and the service that he demonstrated. We thank you, Lord, for the role model that he was to so many of us. And Lord, we confess to you today that there is a void in so many of our lives. Because he's no longer present in this world. But Lord, we know there's a day coming, a great reunion day that's been referred to already. We thank you for that promise, Lord. Give us the faith we need when doubts would ever arise. Give us the faith we need to see life as you see it, to see it through your eyes. For you, Lord, even have made known that you view it. You view the death of a saint as precious in your sight. Apart from faith, humanly speaking, through our physical eyes, we can't understand then how could death be superior to life. But in death, you welcome us into your home. And Father, we just pray that your Holy Spirit today would be in this place and would encourage every heart and encourage the faith that we need to continue and press forward serving you. Thank you for his example. Help us, Lord, to treasure that and to continue to serve you. Lord, may you have your way in each of our lives. In Jesus' name we ask, amen.
I'm kind of homesick for a country to which I've never been, never been before. No sad goodbye. And time won't matter anymore. Beulah land, I'm longing for you. And someday then I'll take. stand. There my home shall be eternal. Beulah land, sweet Beulah land, Beulah land, sweet Beulah land.
Hear the words of comfort from John chapter 14. Jesus to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas says to him, "Lord, we don't know where you are going. So how can we know the way?" And Jesus answered, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." At this time, we're going to have another special.
The swelling tide, when the bright and glorious morning I shall see, I shall know my Redeemer when I reach the other side, and his smile will be the first to welcome me. I shall know him, I shall know him, and redeemed by his side I shall stand. I shall know prints of the nails in his hand. Oh, the soul-thrilling rapture when I view his blessed face and the luster of his kindly beaming eyes. How my full heart will praise him for the mercy, love, and grace that prepare for me a mansion in the sky. I shall know him, I shall know him, and redeemed by his side I shall stand. I shall know him, I shall know him, by the prints of the nails in his hand. Oh, the dear ones in glory, how they beckon me to come, and our parting at the river I recall. To the sweet bells of Eden they will sing my welcome home, but I long to meet my Savior first of all. And I shall know him, I shall know him, and redeemed by his side I shall stand. I shall know him, I shall know him, by the prince of the nails in his hand. Through the gates, to the city in a robe of spotless white. He will lead me nowhere tears will ever fall. In the glad song of ages I shall mingle with delight, but I long to meet my Savior first of all. I shall know him, I shall know him, and redeemed by his side I shall stand. I shall know him, I shall know him, by the prints of the nails in his hand.
At this time, I'd like to ask if there is someone that has something brief that they'd like to share with the family, to give you the opportunity. This will not be your only opportunity. Following the service of committal, the family will be here for lunch, and they invite you to join them. That will probably be about an hour and a half after this service ends, but you are welcome to come and share with them a meal and maybe something from your life that will encourage them in these days. Is there someone that would like to say something this morning? Someone else?
Yeah. Darrell was my best friend in high school. You couldn't have a better friend. He and I, we hunted together. I got to stay at his home when we were in high school, and he came to stay with me at our home. We had a wonderful time together. You couldn't have a better friend than Nick. And we got a chance to bring it full circle at the end, which we got a chance to really say to one another. When we'd come in the room, he would say, "I love you." And when we left, he said the same thing. And I remember one thing about Nick. He looked at me and he said, "You know what?" He said, "We really did good. We got two of the best women that God could ever give us." And I'll never forget that. Darrell was a special person to me. And I look forward, school teacher, to the day that I do get a chance to be reunited with my brother, that we get a chance to live eternity. Can you imagine? Eternity. And just eye has not seen, ears not heard the glories that await for us. And that's a sure thing, because God promised and he keeps his promises. I also know that Darrell is, well, I think this is his sixth day in glory. And I tell you what, it's tremendous. He beat me by 11 years. I didn't give my heart to Jesus until 1985, and he gave his in 1974. But I figure on catching up. I really do. Thank you.
Ed, when I first knew about Darrell, I didn't know him really. And my sister would always come up in the summertime and spend a week. And I actually was jealous of him because he took my sister away. And and then when I finally got married and I really got to know Darrell, and of course, like you, in the beginning, he was Nick. And, I came to love him. And Linda had a fantastic husband. And she was a fantastic wife and a fantastic cook. And he could fillet fish like no one else. And it was just good eating always at their place. But he found out, we were talking, and he found out I'd never been to Gettysburg. And he couldn't believe I'd never been to Gettysburg. So he said, "I have the movie, Gettysburg." He said, "We'll watch that." So we were just gonna watch the one VHS, you know, and watch the other one later. We ended up, Linda went to bed. We ended up watching both. And I don't know what time we got to bed. But we went to Gettysburg, and he could point to every direction and tell what general came from where. And his knowledge was just wonderful, and his enthusiastic preaching was wonderful. And I am going to miss him very much. But I know that when I get to heaven, and at my age, those days aren't going to be too much longer. And I said, I know after I see Jesus, I'm going to look for my family. And we're going to spend eternity together. And I praise God for that.
Last Sunday, we go to Winchester Church of Nazarene. There's a gentleman who shared his testimony and had a tremendous service, and just wave after wave of people coming to the altar after he had shared his testimony of getting far away from God and coming back And I know Dave and have been friends with him for some time, and he shared with me that one of the biggest influences of his life for the good was Darrell and Linda Nicklow. He got long and far away from God, but the people of character in his younger life, he just couldn't get away from, and found his way back to God. Personally, I spent a couple 10-day excursions in the hills of the Rockies with Darrell. And when you spend 10 days in camp, and you get to know people. And just the inner heart of Darrell is his goal. And he's that kind of friend that sticks with you.
Thank you.
I could write a book on his life. I love my Uncle Darrell, and I'm going to miss him, but I'm excited for him. Him and my dad was beautiful, godly men, and what they said and what they preached and what they stood for, they never wavered. And I thank God. And one of the best marriages I've ever seen in my life and family is my Uncle Darrell and Aunt Linda. That didn't mean that they didn't go through hard times, but if you ever want to watch a marriage and a family, better than the Brady Bunch or any of them, because they were real. And my Uncle Darrell had love for life. My Aunt Linda, she was a good cook. She is a good cook. And their kids, I just, their boys are like brothers to me. And he's going to be dearly missed. And I thank you all for being here, sharing this opportunity.
Thank you.
I won't need that, Pastor. I don't have to hold people anyway, but I have a police officer's voice. Hey, I want to start by saying that I want to give praise to our God in heaven for Pastor Nicklow. I first heard him on WJSM his Saturday radio. God spoke to my heart through him. He's such a wonderful person. He'll certainly be missed. He spoke powerfully, but he spoke God's word, and God used him in such a way that I believe that he's touched many people's lives, not only my own, but many, many others. And again, praise and thanks to God for that. And for Miss Linda also, even though I probably bent her ear a few times sitting behind her saying, yeah, he's going to be missed. Thank you.
Thank you, Ron.
Hi, my name's Trista, and I've been a member of this church for the past 17, almost 18 years. I just want to say what an honor it was to be able to have such an amazing role model. If it wasn't for Pastor Nicklow, I wouldn't be where I am today in my faith. He led me to God. And he'll be dearly missed, but I have peace in my heart knowing where he went. And I thank God every day for him and Miss Linda. They were such amazing people in my life. And I'm so blessed for all the times I'd be going through such a hard time in my life. And that Sunday, he'd preach about something, that exact thing I was going through. And I just, God used him to impact people's lives in such an amazing way. And he was so special to so many, and he's truly a blessing. And I can't wait one day to be able to meet him again in heaven. And I'm so blessed for the both of them. I truly am. Thank you.
I'm definitely not one to speak in front of nobody. Pastor meant the world to me. Many, many years ago when they came, I've known them for the whole 28 and a half years. They came, I was pregnant, and I had my first child, so my children is the only pastor they knew. But many years ago, I went through a very, very hard time. I was at the end of my life, and not like sickness, but mentally. And the pastor and Linda, they helped me. And he literally saved my life through God and him. I'm gonna miss him so very much. And the last few days we were up visiting him. He was pretty bad, and he'd blink his eyes a few times. He said, "Hi, Waylon, hi, Stephanie." And we went back to sleep, and we visited with Miss Linda, and then right before we left, she said, "Do you know they're here?" And he just said yes, and he raised his hand, and we grabbed his hand, and he said, "We love you," and he said, "I love you back." So I got to hear his words, and I just want to let the family know I really loved him, and he was the best pastor I've ever had.
When I came to the church and I met Pastor and Miss Linda, they took me in with open arms, and I had many talks with them, and they knew I had my struggles, but every time I struggled, I knew that I could come to them. And Pastor helped me with my walk with the Lord for the first time, and I knew I could always, there was many a times, like when he knew I was feeling down, they would just say, "Come over to the parsonage after church," and they would sit and talk to me and pray with me. And, you know, we did things together. I helped them through things, they helped me. And I remember the one time he was talking to me about the elk. And I said, "Well, I never got to see the elk." And he said, "Well, you will." So him and Miss Linda went with me one day. It was a rainy day. It was a very rainy day. And he said, "Oh, I wish we could get out and you could hear them bugle." And I mean, he was just like a kid telling me about the elk. And we had the best day ever that day. And someday I hope to go see the elk again, and I can sit and think about Pastor Nicklow and how much he loved seeing the elk. But you know, when they take you in, they love you. They love you deeply. And they took me in as part of their family. And I love this family dearly. And I love Pastor Nicklow. But I know I will see you again someday. God bless you, Pastor Nicklow, and I will always love you.
Started this church. here 28 and a half years. And we just love the family so much. We watched them grow up from here. And I just thank the Lord for sending us Pastor Darrell.
I don't know if I should say something before I sing because I might not make it through the song. But I will. Pastor Nicklow has been a mentor to me. He, like my wife said, they came right before our first child was born. And we loved them instantly. And the friendship, just like a family, between Pastor Nicklow, Miss Linda, and us was deep. And they would do anything for you. And I've always said, especially to their boys, I would do anything for them. I remember one conversation we had a couple years ago. I think it was about 3 years ago. And he was actually talking about he didn't know how long he was going to preach yet. He called me in the office one day and he said, I don't know how long I'm going to preach yet. He says, but I'm going to, and this is just Pastor Darrell. He said, I'm going to preach till I can't preach anymore. And he did. And the Lord used him mightily. In my family, in this church, in this community, and who knows how far, based on the radio ministry. And we started recording messages and putting them on our YouTube channel back in 2015. Every sermon he ever preached since then is still out there on our YouTube channel. You want to hear some good preaching, go back to our YouTube channel. Every message he ever preached from 2015 on is on there. And I thank the Lord every day for him and Miss Linda coming here and being such a blessing to us, this church, and this community. I love them with all my heart. Now I hope I get through this song. I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Yeah. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. I can only imagine. When that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun, I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah.
imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Yeah. Is forever worship you. I can only imagine. 40 years
I've loved you guys, and for 40 years you guys have loved us, and we thank you for it. Joshua 1, 5 through 9. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you or forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate it on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will prosper and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Thank you, Reverend Dunlop. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, Lord of all creation, you alone understand the way that you made us. When you sent your Son, it's recorded for us that when he stood by the grave, he wept. Father, may we find comfort in you, the God of all comfort. May we not be afraid to cry like our Savior. Touch our hearts with your presence. May your word bring strength. And may your Spirit bring peace, in Jesus' name. The believer in Jesus Christ has committed himself or herself and their life to this understanding of kingdom life. in death or in life, may Jesus be lifted up. Today we're gathered to celebrate both the life and, in this case, the death of a pastor, husband, father, brother, son, grandfather, and a committed follower of Jesus Christ. Let's consider the life of a believer and just three things that we find in the scriptures. You see, believers live a life that does not necessarily mend. Imperfect, broken, but in Christ, redeemed. You see, many have endured imperfect lives and suffering, and we find them recorded in Scripture. Job, Paul, Jesus. From James chapter 5, many have endured imperfect. Brothers and sisters, as an example of patience in the face of suffering, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. As you know, we count as blessed those who have persevered. You have heard of Job's perseverance and have seen what the Lord finally brought about. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. And from the pen of Paul in 2 Corinthians, to keep me from being conceited, I was given a thorn in my flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me. Three times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away. But he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions." Paul decided he would boast in these things. He said, "For when I am weak, then I am strong." The Messiah, he fasted, was tempted, and faced the crucifixion because of the one he served. He did not shy away, and as we know, neither did Pastor Darrell. You see, believers live a life that is not necessarily one that is easy to mend. But God sympathizes with the sufferer and gives strength. In Psalm chapter 34, we read, "The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are attentive to their cry. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to blot out their name from the earth. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those that are crushed in spirit." God is our refuge. He is our strength and ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though the waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. Psalm 46. God's desire is for relationship. In our imperfection, his glory can be seen as we build a relationship with him of love and trust in our Heavenly Father. Darrell told me about how God saved him. There, as I stood at his bedside, about how God in his grace found him, how he showed him great mercy and grace. He told me about one night where he was in a position that, had he been there just a short time later, instead of going with a friend, he would have died. This led him to seek God in a revival service. Linda said the only one he ever went to at that age. He told me that he believed God spared his life and that he was led to give it back through serving the Lord. We know that his life is not perfect, that trials came in his life, and that he needed God's presence and his peace, especially in these last years. His life on earth just would not mend. However, we find that Pastor Darrell lived life differently. You see, he also lived a life that does not bend. In Scripture, we find those that their life did not bend no matter what came. Nehemiah, Daniel, and his Savior, Jesus. In Nehemiah, we read the following, "Hear us, O God, for we are despised. Turn their insults back on their own heads." There are moments when in righteousness we can ask God to take care of us. "Give them over as plunder in a land of captivity. Do not cover up their guilt or blot out their sins from your sight, for they have thrown insults in the face of the builders." And then he reports, "So we rebuilt the wall till all of it reached half its height, for the people worked with all their heart because they were following a man who had given his heart completely to God the Father." Today we've heard testimony about how others have been challenged to live a life that will not bend because of Pastor Darrell's. Daniel, he answered, "May the king live forever. My God sent his angel and shut the mouths of the lions. They have not hurt me because I was found innocent in God's sight. Nor have I ever done any wrong before you, your majesty." When you read Daniel's life, you see a young man that began with an unbending idea of who his God was. And our Savior. From Matthew chapter 20. Now Jesus was going up to Jerusalem. On the way, he took the 12 aside and said to them, "We are going up to Jerusalem. And the Son of Man will be delivered over to the chief priests and teachers of the law. They will condemn him to death and will hand him over to the Gentiles to be mocked and flogged and crucified. On the third day, he will be raised to life." Jesus stands outside of time, and he knows all that will happen and all that has happened. And he tried to share with his disciples something that we need to understand this morning as well. We can live a life that does not bend because of who we serve. Pastor Darrell has led the way. In 6 different assignments all across Western PA, Darrell lived a life that did not bend. He stood firm, not only preaching, but believing God's word and trusting his promises till the end. As a pastor, he exhibited kindness, care, challenge, commitment, both to the congregation, to the community, and to his family. Here in Orby and in Rock Hill for 28 and a half years, he served God and this congregation. His reward will reflect his willingness to stand firm and not bend. Pastor Darrell believed in Scripture. And he believed that the Scriptures also promised a life that does not end. A life that does not end. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." A life that begins now and spans eternity when we relinquish the life that we live now in light of eternity. Very truly, I tell you, a time is coming and now has come when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to judge because he is the Son of Man. Do not be amazed at this, for a time is coming when all who are in their graves will hear his voice and come out. Those who have done what is good will rise to live, and those who have done what is evil will rise to be condemned. And finally, Jesus, as he approached the grave of Lazarus, he said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. No one, the one who believes in me will live even though he die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die." Do you believe this? Our suffering here is insignificant when compared with eternal joy, but it is significant at the time. We can grieve because of our loss, because God has made us for relationship, but we do not need to grieve for all eternity. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory. It far outweighs them all. And Paul, the writer of Romans, "I consider our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed to us." This is my attempt to bring things full circle. But Pastor Darrell would say, as he did when he stood here last, he would say, "I want you to know that above all else that I have preached and all that I have taught, a relationship with the living Lord is what will see us through eternity. That relationship is found in no one except Christ, the Son of God, who lived, ministered, died, and rose again. For in all of these, he stood in our place that we might see his example and trust his free gift. This is why we live. And this is why there can, in our death, be glory. It is only found in salvation in Jesus Christ. If you don't have that relationship, Darrell would say, not only will I pray for you, but can I pray with you? And maybe that's where you stand or sit this morning. Don't be afraid. Trust. And if you need someone to pray with, please find myself. Find someone who gave testimony this morning to the fact that Jesus saves. Let us pray together. Father, as we consider all that we have heard and all that we have sung, we are asking for your presence in these moments, for your peace for this life, and for a strength to live a life that does not bend or end, in spite of the fact that we are broken. We ask, Father, that as we sing together in a moment, our hearts would be touched by the truth of this, one of Pastor Darrell's favorite songs. Hear our praise, we ask, in Jesus' name.
been seated for quite some time. Would you please stand if you're able? Turn in your hymnals with me to hymn number 33, one of Reverend Nicklow's favorite hymns, How Great Thou Art. Hymn number 33, How Great Thou Art. Consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Amen. You may be seated for a moment. We're going to receive some instructions. This ends the service here. The family will be headed out to the committal in just a little bit, but I believe we have some instructions.